You know what we're going to talk about today. We are going to dive into the new Sonia G Pro Face Set. When her Pro Eye Set launched, we all lost our minds and heard around the corner that she was going to come out with a Face Pro version. Every time she does her individual Instagram post for each brush, my heart starts just racing more and more every time. Today, we'll talk about each brush, what they're designed to do, close-up shots, demos for each brush, and we're gonna get in-depth, okay? You know how I love to chat. There will be timestamps down below for each brush. If you don't care about all of them and just wanna see one, you know where to go. So if you wanna see the brushes from the new Sonia G Pro Face Set, then please keep on watching. Hey friends, my name is Alicia, and welcome to Kinky Sweat, a platform where I share all things movement and beauty. If you're into makeup, flexibility, movement life, hair, skincare, you've come to the right place. All my movements will be found on my Instagram, daily adventures of my trainings and teachings. But we're gonna talk about this package we got today. Oh, I received the UPS updates. Yes, I did. I knew when she was gonna come. If you haven't already, if you're a fan and want to know more in depth about each brush, go to Sonia's Instagram posts. She breaks down each brush, compares them with other brushes within the same shape and task realm, and the inspiration behind the design, which is a reason why I love to invest in her brushes. She just doesn't make brushes. She has a story for each design. I feel it just heightens the connection to a product. I know it's just a makeup brush, but some makeup brushes you see, they're expensive. What's the story? Why is it that expensive? Behind the craftsmanship, the reason why it's designed the way it is, I just feel heightens the experience of her brushes. And the fact that she is just incredibly sweet and she just wants everyone to enjoy her brushes. That's all she wants. And she just wants everyone to have the most sublime experience using her brushes. So, first of all, let me go back to my text, because you know anytime you go on the pre-sale list for a Beautylish releases. Let me find it. Alexis was so nice in helping me this time around, but I forget when that was. Alexis sent this to me last Wednesday because the pre-sale launched last Wednesday, but the brushes actually went on sale that Saturday, the 26th. You have exclusive early access to Sonia G's new Pro Face Set. Would you like me to pre-order? I was like, yes, please. This was packaged and sent from Philadelphia. That's what the box says. Yes, that's what it says. Came here today, so under a week, which is great. And she was so nice. She was like, I watch your YouTube videos. I'm like, get out of here, small world. Thank you again, Alexis, for helping me with my purchase. I cannot wait to finally dive in. These brushes are currently still in stock, I believe. Before I say lies, oh, out of stock. Well, when I checked yesterday, it was still in stock. It's really hard to keep up, you know what I mean? Get on the list for the restock, and I do believe she will eventually sell these individually. If you're not into investing in a whole brush set and there's one in particular that you think will change your life, you can just get that one. The whole set does retail for $270. Without a doubt, it is expensive. If you're into brushes and a flawless makeup application, that's all I got. That's all I want to say. All right, here's the package. It's the package. Oh, I cannot wait. Beautylish, a beautiful, Lilith's nice note. So good to see you again. Is this from you, Alexis? Let me know. We hope you love your new Sonia G Pro Face Set. Thank you always for shopping with us. See you soon. Oh, you will. And the featured sample that they usually like to include in their package orders is a Sulwhasoo Concentrated Jensen Renewing Eye Cream. Not only do they provide deluxe samples, but they also have a product card with the actual sample that tells you what the full-size product is, and it has some details about what it's designed to do. I think that is such a nice perk. I'll be using you later. Look how cute this is. Isn't this adorable? I absolutely love this packaging. It just makes for a, I can't find the words. It's exciting. It makes it exciting to receive packages from Beautylish. Here they are. Fresh out of their plastic sleeve. Ooh, okay. Let's calm down. Relax. The Face Pro. Which one is the Face Pro? I think it's the biggest one here. Yep. Here it is. Now, from comparing her Pro eye set to the original eye brushes. I think she wanted to create a set that not only for professionals, but for makeup enthusiasts alike. I'm going over to her Instagram because she just articulates so well in what she wants to achieve in creating these brushes and these brush sets. You know what I mean? Wait. Oh my goodness. Look how beautiful this is. Look at the handle. It's tapered. Her original face brushes are not. For instance, this is the sculpt one. It has a more wider barrel handle. So this is how the handles look against each other. I prefer the tapered handle. I think aesthetically, I just like it better, but to each his own. On her Instagram post, she says, I aimed for a brush that would feel safe in any situation with any product and effortless at any skill level, from the pro makeup artist to the person who has never used a makeup brush before. This is the essential all-over powder and bronzer brush. There is no caution required. You can grab it to do a few swipes and you're ready to go. Oh, I love it. It is made with a mix of undyed and dyed Saikoho goat bristles, really helpful in terms of maintenance as it won't look as dirty when dirty. But most importantly, the mix of these two different bristles brought me the results I was looking for. Oh yes, the perfect fusion of softness and strength. What I feel about contortion. This combination adds airiness and flexibility to the bristles and makes the brush splay out while keeping a great grip on the more tougher products. This combo is not only mesmerizing to look at, you are very mesmerizing, but mixed together, they bring out the best in both. It is meant to be used with powders, finishing powders, bronzers, also blush when we don't require a precise application and we just want to add dimension or very subtle sculpting of the face. The shape is angled and slightly tapered to allow moderate precision with the placement and the application. All right. Hold on. We gotta apply some foundation first. I don't know what the individual costs for these brushes are. I'm sure she will eventually have those details soon. It's getting darker every minute. Come on, light. I'm going to apply a little bit of my Hourglass Vanish Liquid Seamless something, something, something. It's a very long name. Sorry. Going with my Chikohoto Foundation Beautylish collab brush. I'm gonna quickly buff that into the skin. As you know, Sonia G brushes are made in Japan. They are hand bundled, thus why the very high price. And they're natural hair, but they're not just any natural hair. I mean, they're the softest of the softest natural hair. Okay. All right, foundation is on. Now we can start with these powders. Oh, but should we apply some? Okay, fine. We'll apply some concealer too. I'm only putting a little bit. I mean, this is not a look by any means. Fenty Instant Retouch in the shade 300. I'm gonna buff that out quickly just so we could, you know, get this demo started. I'm just gonna lightly just... There we go, done. I'm just putting a little bit on my lids because I don't want them to look totally weird and discolored while in this demo. I'm just gonna brush my brow hair so they don't look so crazy. At least, you know, they are microbladed, so I don't really need to color them in anyway. All right, bronzer and finishing powder. I feel though, wait. First of all, the softness of this brush is insane. Look how beautifully shaped it is. It is slanted and it is slightly tapered, and the way it just hugs the face and glides over the skin is a divine experience. I'm telling you. Before we get in, foundation is on. She could sit there a little bit. Let's actually go through all the brush details first and then we'll start the demo from there. I apologize if I'm jumping around a lot. I am just so excited. The next brush she breaks down is the Inochige. How do you pronounce that word, Sonia? I'm sorry. In calligraphy, a brush is more than a writing tool. It's an extension of the mind and the body of the calligrapher. I agree. From the very bottom of the handle to the very top of the bristles, this brush was inspired by the art of calligraphy, adapting its purpose to fit those of the makeup artist. As I was explaining all the details about the design and the performance of this brush to the artisans, they kept referring it to as the is the most important and precious part in a calligraphy brush. It's the heart of the brush. Because this word was so important in the understanding and making of this particular feud. Is that how you say that word too? I'm the worst. I want it to remain with the brush. That's why she just named it this.
There it is.
It is very dense at the base. The density decreases halfway up where it becomes just airy enough so that the bristles that touch the skin can still move easily to apply and blend with no pressure, no effort, and the most satisfying control. After washing it and using it a few times, it still remains tapered, allowing precision at the tip, but the body blooms, and because of its medium size, it offers great versatility. It is fantastic to set the foundation with pressed or loose powders, a dream with bronzer or powders to add structure to the face, but it also works wonders when it comes to blush application. Oh, if you own the Blender Pro, I do, hold on, let me get it. This brush offers the same kind of experience. It feels like a massage on the skin as all bristles move in a perfect harmony. The experience is divine and the results beyond expectations. The way she describes her freaking brushes, I mean, the picture she paints, it is transcendent. Okay, she's taking you there within that realm of experience. She's not just saying you can use it with powders. No. She's saying, this is how it's going to change your life. All right, we're going to have you on standby. Oh, so beautiful. Next up, we have the Cheek Pro. Is this the Cheek Pro? Yes, it is. Check out this beautiful brush head. Oh, just the color is, I cannot. Let's read. I love brushes and especially shades that are closer to my skin tone. Unfortunately, when we need to build up neutral or softer shades, these tend to be more difficult to work with. And then we struggle to get an application that stays put. I get it. This little Cheek Pro brush is at the same time super cute and truly efficient.
You are.
It works with the type of finish matte sparkly gelé frost hybrids gel powder formulas. If you usually cannot get any color payoff, this one will definitely work wonders. And the post before she started announcing her individual brush details, she also mentioned this palette that was a little tough to work with because of that gelé type formula. It's the NARS Holiday Hot Trees Cheek Palette. These are the types of formulas she's referring to. Like, they're very tough to pick up. It's like barely there, but apparently this brush is supposed to make it happen for us today. So I'm gonna have her on standby. I'm gonna use you. The bristles are quite short and quite dense, as you see in the comparison pics. They will facilitate the work on smallest pans post-wash. They splay out nicely to a paddle pom-pom shape and deliver a diffuse application on the cheeks. Combining strength and softness in the same little brush is always quite a challenge, but it was achieved in such an amazing way. You can use it for blush, but also to sculpt, set, polish, highlight. This little brush is such a versatile tool, both in personal and professional makeup kits. Love her. All right, Cheek Pro, we're gonna use that. We're gonna use that for the cheeks. Up next, we have, oh, this is one of the face detail. One of my heavily anticipated brushes that I wanted to use. Look at her. Isn't she simply gorgeous? Look at the color. It's the same dyed, undyed combination from the Face Pro, but this is the small face detail pro brush. When creating this pro set, kept thinking about the editorial looks which fascinate me, and I wanted a tool to do more detailed placement and work. You can think about this brush as a chubby crease blender type of brush in terms of shape, but it's not really for crease definition. This is to precisely set the lids or other areas of the face, to sculpt, to paint with powder products. It was all about a small versatile tool that had to easily fit in eyeshadow pans that we could work with any eyeshadow onto the face. Like we did with our tri-palette. You'll see what I mean? This brush makes you feel like an artist working on a canvas. The whole experience is an absolute treat and is also very special to me, as this is a brush I will for sure use daily to set my lids or specific small areas, like my nose. With this brush, I had the same challenges as with the Face Pro brush. Using only dyed goat bristles was making the application too directional and heavy, and I wanted to offer the possibility to build the color gradually, highlight or contour smaller areas without harsh edges. No. Adding the white undyed bristles in the mix made it just right. You get enough grip to work with pressed powders. Even the difficult ones you can build gradually from the intensity on the skin. It's effortless from the moment you pick the product until the very final blending.
Okay, the final brush, here she comes.
I lost her for a second.
Gianni, she escaped my sight.
Finally, we have the Fan Pro. Look how beautifully shaped this fan brush is. I cannot. It is based on the best-selling Sculpt 3, similar size and shape. I only have Sculpt 1 and 2, but the Sculpt 3 at the time when I bought my 1 and 2 was sold out. Similar size and shape, goat side coho bristles too, but here they are not dyed, which means we can safely use it with creams. Yes! It works so well with both powders and solid creams. I often use it with highlighters that come in a stick packaging. Do I have something like that? Yes, I do! That have a more solid or sticky type of finish. There are some fun hybrid formulas around. This little fan can handle them so beautifully. If you pick the product with the Fan Pro and then sweep it onto the skin, the glow equals glass skin. We want that. And it won't disturb the underneath application. It's absolutely gorgeous. Oh, you are so gorgeous. Sculpt 3 was created with an intention to deliver high impact instantly and work with difficult to pick up products. This pro version is more wispy and will splay out more with time. It will also offer a more progressive approach, starting with a more see-through application, building up the intensity, and it's also more appropriate across the all types of finishes. I love a precise application of glow, and I'm literally obsessed. Yes, say it. Say it, Sonia, and the application they provide. I could not see this pro set without one. It's both about the beauty of this brush and the fun with the application. All right, friends, we have our brushes, the details for each, what they're meant to do. So let's get on this demo. I'm gonna use this to set the under eyes, why not? And then I'm gonna use the Bigger Face Pro to set the rest of my face. I just wanna do everything. Can't you tell? Before I set the under eyes, I want to try the Fan Pro with my Hourglass Champagne Flash Stick, because since it said you could technically use it for these hard to pick up stick highlighter things, and I don't want to set my under eyes and then not show up. So let's do that right now. I know I didn't wash these. They're straight out of the box. Please forgive me. I simply could not have waited until tomorrow. Again, this is in the shade Champagne Flash from the Hourglass Vanish highlighting stick. So we're gonna, oh wait, I need a mirror. I'm trying to get as much as I can and see up close. Oh yeah, there it is. It's very hard to see, I understand, but you know what, I don't mind, because that in itself is a very light placement of glow that I appreciate. But that's pretty nice. That gives a really nice soft glow, and it doesn't look chunky or sparkly. First of all, can I just say how beautifully soft this brush feels? I mean, and it just fits perfectly onto the cheekbone, and the placement is, I mean, perfect. That's so nice. I love it. All right, we love you, Fan Pro. Done. Let's now set the under eyes. I have my mini Hourglass translucent veil powder. I know it's not an all Hourglass video, okay? It's just I'm working from my overnight bag, and it just so happens to have taking the special name calligraphy brush under the eyes. I don't want to move from this spot. This brush, first of all, look how beautifully it moves, and look how just the shape of it is. I mean, this is the most beautiful tapered brush I have ever seen. Like, the way it's designed and how it glides across the skin and how it's absolutely perfect for under eye loose powder placement. I mean, please, and look how beautifully it rolls across the skin and how it splays a little bit when you press the brush more onto the face. It's gorgeous. Ooh, 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 oh yes, oh yeah. Okay, we love that, we love you. Okay, let's apply now to the rest of the face. Oh, I recently applied my Fenty Instant Retouch Loose powder on my Hourglass Vanish liquid yesterday. I applied a little too much, I can't lie. So perhaps the Face Pro would just allow for a more lighter application of that loose powder. So let's go in with the Face Pro. I'm going in with the shade Honey from the Fenty Instant Retouch Setting Loose Powder. I'm just taking very lightly on the brush, and we're gonna get in on that. This brush is so soft, it's kind of insane. It feels sublime on my skin. The way this is gliding across my face, oh my Holy heavens. This is so nice. This is just the best. There's so many things I want to do. I'm gonna do one side with Anastasia bronzer using this brush, and then I want to use the cheek brush with an Hourglass, the mini bronzing pan in one of their face palettes. So I'm gonna grab my bronzing powder from ABH in the shade Cappuccino, and we're just gonna That was flawless. That was a flawless application of bronzing. Wow. The hugging, the embrace. That is so ideal for bronzer. Oh my goodness. Perfect. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. For this cheek brush, I want to go in now with my bronzer powder pan in the Unlock palette. See how that goes. Oh, this brush. You need to stop being so soft, okay? You're getting out of control. I keep lighting you up because it's just progressively getting darker and darker as the day goes. It's fine. Oh, I love this. And look, because it's pinched, it's also ideal for nose bridge application. Just take it under here. Oh, that is divine. Oh, I love it. And just to see, so I'm gonna go in with my Makeup Forever Artist Sculpt Powder and just... Oh, whoa, you're not playing around. But see, this is what we can do. We can do this. We could also do this. Fine by me. We could also try with the Cheek Pro, again, with the Artist Color Powder. We could try this. I love it. Let's carve out again on this side, shall we? Love. What I'm really excited about is to finally dip into this hard to work with NARS palette. It's not hard to work with, but because of the finish of the powders, these can be a little difficult to pick up, and you wonder when applying your makeup, you're like, is it on there? I don't know. You tell me. Let's try this shade. I am dying to find out. Well, you know what? Hold on. We can do this in several ways. Let's go in with the Detail Pro because, oh my goodness, I just cannot wait to see what this does. Oh, that is absolutely perfect. Oh my goodness. Let's try this light color, like just for kicks. Right on top. Let's just put some in here. There you go. The brow bone. There you go. Get it right in between. There you go. Cupid's bow. There you go. It looks so smooth. It doesn't look textured at all. And the softness, I mean, the silkiness of these brushes, I just cannot comprehend in words. I cannot. It looks so natural and low key. It does not look like it's sitting on the skin at all. I'm gonna go in now with the fan brush with the same color and very appreciative of the size. Yes. I'm actually just going between the two. I'm just gonna do this. Because you know what? We ain't here to play. See, now I can use this palette. I haven't been just because, you know? Let's use the Cheek Pro because she had mentioned that she wanted to create a brush for hard to pick up formulas for small pan sizes. So let's see. Let's do one side this color. I'm doing the wiggle. Doing the wiggle. Oh, this is like the foolproof blush formula. Besides the Hourglass, these gelé types of formulas, like, you can't screw up. You simply can't. Let's go in now with like a crazy color. I'm putting that higher on the cheekbones, and then I'm gonna go in with, I don't know, like this color. Oh yeah, now she's showing up. I'm gonna try this color. What does that do? Oh, that's fun as well. I'm just gonna put these two on this is my right to make it a little more even. I'm gonna use the calligraphy brush to just buff all those powders in. My skin looks so smooth. It looks airbrushed, poreless. It doesn't look textured. I mean, the way these brushes apply product is beyond me. Am I exaggerating? No. And the way my skin feels is just ultimately soft. It's, oh my goodness. What do I want to do? I kind of want to use this as like, we use it as the detail. We also could use it for very intense contour, I think she said, for those like avant-garde editorial looks, perhaps. Should we go in with like, I don't know. Let's go in with the Anastasia bronzer, but use the Detail Pro for like crease stuff. Oh yeah, that got it on really fast. And I love this for no makeup days, because actually that happened to me when I was staying over at Maddie's house. I forgot to pack an eyeshadow palette. I just forgot. I use my bronzer as like my crease color to add a little bit of warmth, and use my highlighting shade as my standout lip color. That was a wrap. But this is also ideal if, because sometimes it happens, you've seen it on my videos, I take it too far out, I overblend. You can take a pressed powder, whether it's your skin tone or a translucent color, and use this brush to just help refine the edges and take the blending down so it doesn't look as messy. Oh, this brush is gonna be a favorite. I wanna use the Fan Pro with like a crazy highlight shade. I'm gonna go back into my custom Makeup Forever palette. I believe this is H106. It's either H106 or H108 between the banana and the champagne highlight. Mm-hmm. Well, that's freaking flawless. And I also do this application the pull down way with my sculpt number 2, because I just love, again, the design of the brush and how it places the powder perfectly to where I want it to go on my cheekbone. That is so pretty. Oh my goodness me. And if you want to do a final buff, you can take your favorite loose powder, your favorite radiant powder, and just go over the whole look using the Face Pro. I'm looking real no makeup, makeup great and natural. What do you think, friends? Before I go any further, this video is not to make you buy expensive brushes. You know how much I love Sonia G and how I support her. If you are thinking about buying the set or buying these individually and you want to see how they perform, what they're used for, find out if it will enhance your makeup application, if you care for that to happen. I'm not making you buy anything. I just want that to be very clear, because in this day and age when people want to save money and they get, I don't want to say sensitive, but they feel like all these influencers are telling me to spend my money, and how could you ask or make someone buy an expensive brush? This is for fun. Listen, I bought these myself. I love Sonia G brushes, and I love the experience that they yield. I do feel that her brushes enhance my makeup experience, and my makeup looks like the best it has ever been ever since using Wayne and Sonia brushes. That's not to discredit the other brushes out there that are cheaper, that they can still provide beautiful results without a doubt. This is my experience, what I felt, what I believe in, and if you don't want to buy Sonia G, Wayne Goss, Hakuhodo, Chikuhodo, anything, then you don't have to. If you are thinking about it and if it's on your radar, then I can help you out in choosing what to buy, okay? Okay. I love these brushes! They are beyond anything I could have expected, wanted. Everything she said about each brush is nailed down. I mean, down to the application technique, to the type of medium you use them with, the results that you should expect. They really do enhance your makeup application experience. I am so happy I bought these. I'm gonna use them every day, and you might just see them in my January favorites. Don't know when I'm gonna film that vid, and I know I just got them today, and February is like in 2 days. But you know how I roll. I'm just gonna give you that warning. You're welcome. I don't know when the restock is gonna be, and just from this first impressions, I can't pin down one brush that I would recommend that you buy. I think as I was talking to my friend Susan Mayfield, hey Susan, she was figuring out which set she should invest in, and then I asked her, which do you prioritize more, your eye makeup application or your complexion? And she was like, eyes for sure. But maybe she won't get the whole Face Pro. Maybe there's a step in her makeup application that she finds that, or anyone for that matter, they get stuck in. They don't like how their loose powders apply. They don't like how their bronzers apply. I would then get one one brush that kind of tackles loose powder, bronzer, and blush, and it could do all things for you. Like, this is a great multitasker. Like Sonia said, you could apply loose powder, pressed powder, bronzer, a light diffuse wash of blush. You could even probably use this. You know, Sonia Deluxe loves to use big brushes for her highlighting application. Why not? You could use that on the cheekbone and just have a really nice wash of highlighting application on the cheekbone. If you love detail work and you don't have a brush that provides flawless results for detail work, maybe you'll get the Detail Pro, right? Or maybe you need that specially designed fan brush that's natural hair and super soft and will make your highlighting experience beyond. Maybe you need the ultra tapered brush that's going to give you the loose powder application, the bronzer and the contour and the blush and whatever. Or maybe you just need one brush that needs to fit in a smaller face palette pan for harder to pick up formulas that you haven't been experiencing because you haven't found the right brush. These are the questions that you have to ask yourself, and don't feel like you have to buy the whole set. If you love collecting brushes, then that's you, right? If you want this whole set because you just want it, you don't have any particular makeup application needs to be addressed, then fine, you do what you need to do, okay? But what I will say, sorry, was I too light? What I will say is, do I highly recommend this? Absolutely. Sonia G does not disappoint. She is very passionate about releasing tools that she believes in, that she works heavily on with the artisans. She's not just, you know, giving feedback here and there. She is involved in this process of the design, what task she wants these brushes to cover, because she loves makeup herself, right? And she wants us to have an equally sublime experience with makeup tools. Again, I'm a fan. I highly recommend them. I will, again, the more I use them and the more I learn about them, I could break down which brush would be best for what task, what purpose. If you're wondering about one in particular for one type of application, ask away. Let me know down below. Let me know if you've got your face pro set and what you think about it. And we'll take it from there. And that, my friends, it's a wrap. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope this video helped. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And until then, I'll see you on here again with another tutorial, chit-chat, demo, review, or unboxing. Take care, and I'll see you again soon.